Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. The Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. In all praise we bring to you, 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 all praise we bring to you. 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 Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy. To receive blessing, or to receive glory, to receive honor and all praise, or to receive blessing, to receive glory, to receive honor, to receive all praise, to receive blessing. To receive honor, to receive glory, to receive our praise. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. receive all blessing, all honor, and all glory, and all praise. Receive all blessing, all honor, all glory, and all praise. We worship you, oh Lord. Oh, we worship you, oh Lord. We worship you, oh Lord. Oh, we worship you, oh Lord. Oh, we worship you, oh Lord, oh, we worship you, oh Lord. Jesus, oh Jesus, oh, we worship you, oh Lord. 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 Oh, we worship you, oh Lord.
Was slain for my sins, Jesus, Jesus, name above all names, Jesus, King of all kings, Lord.
Worship you, Prince of Peace. And the sounds of praise. Oh, oh, with the songs and the sounds of praise. Oh, with the songs and the sounds of praise. Oh, with the songs and the sounds of praise. We worship you. We worship you.
The one who delivered me from the power of death and the grave, Jesus, Jesus, Savior, Deliverer, Deliverer. Redeemer, Redeemer. You just stop and you think a minute. The reality of it is every single soul is going to stand before a living God, and he has already judged that everyone who ever commits a sin is worthy of death because it's such an offense to what he created us to be. But the Redeemer came and redeemed us from the power of sin and disobedience. All we have to do is be willing to say, Lord, I want you to come and rescue me. And he will respond to anyone who asks. There's a lot of people who stand on the sidelines wondering. But I'm going to tell you, 1 second after you breathe out your last breath, All the wondering ceases and eternity begins. There's not a soul on the earth that has the right, the power, the intellect, the understanding to deny the only one who came and said, I am the living God. There is no other beside me. I am the truth, the way, the life. No man comes unto the Father except by me. He's the only one that was proclaimed to be the power that washes away every sin, every form of disobedience, changes and restores everything the Father purposed twisted man to be. Father, we thank you that you came and you created us anew in your image and your glory. You shaped us all over again, just like you shaped the first man. You shaped us, oh God, not from the fine dust of the earth, but you shaped us by your Holy Spirit after the glory of the only begotten Son, Christ Jesus. I'm so glad that Jesus set me free. I'm so glad that Jesus set me free. I'm so glad. Woo! Come on, shout a little bit. I mean, we don't want to force praise and thanksgiving out of anybody's life and heart. But just look what God did for you. Just believe just a little bit more what God has in store, what he's done already. And you can't help but get really excited. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my God.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord. And all that is within me, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Come bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. And all that is within me.
Oh, all that is within me. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord.
Such a blessed gift of grace that Father has allowed us to belong to Him, to be the household of faith. I mean, He so set His affections upon us that He came and purchased us. He paid more than a trillion. He paid more than multiplied trillions. He took all the riches of heaven that were just found and discovered and revealed in Christ Jesus. And Father, with the precious blood and the life of Jesus. Jesus had to bear the reproach, the shame, the poverty, the rejection, the reproofs, the persecution, the affliction, and the torment that men, that's basically about what men give to each other, you know. And so it wasn't odd that they should give it to Jesus, God manifested in the flesh as well. Hallelujah. Huh? But He didn't have to do it. He did it to redeem you and me from the curse of sin and death and the power of hell. And somebody said, why is it that you stand around and shout and get so excited with joyful music? Because this is real to me. I had an encounter with reality, the spirit of truth, that which the intellect cannot conceive nor understand, came and made known the one, the man, Christ Jesus, to me. And He wants to do the same for you. Listen, you're just going to have to just begin to just get excited about what you know in God right now. If all you know is Jesus loves me, that should be enough to get you basically jumping as high as the moon. Give me a break. If all you know is God so loved the world, that should get you enough to start jumping around, dancing around, and shouting for the rest of your life. Just go with what you know and be obedient. God will show you more. He'll bring you into it. Listen, He's purposed to fill you with heaven. You can be filled with all the rest of this nonsense if you should so desire and will. But that just is simply a declaration that you're still walking in ignorance, in the blindness of heart that has kept you from understanding the beauty of heaven. For no one would see the beauty of heaven and the glory that Father has purchased for us in Christ Jesus and then walk away and go waller in the in the things of filthiness. God's poured out his spirit of holiness. I get to live in Woo! I get to live in heaven every day. Somebody says, what about the money? Who cares? I'm living in heaven every day. Somebody says, what about the house and the living arrangements? Who cares? I'm living in heaven every day. Somebody said, what about the car and the stuff? Who cares? I'm living in heaven. I'm living in a realm that is about to be revealed. When we step from this life into the next life of the great glorious riches of God that go beyond anything that man could ever attain with his own works or by his own power. People labor for things that do not profit. They give their lives for that which cannot in any way bring them any kind of gains spiritually, physically, and emotionally. And today God's going to give you an opportunity to get off that monkey go round. Amen. Hallelujah. You get to jump that thing. You get to jump off that silly, ridiculous thing. Now I'm telling you, it's an amazing thing. You're standing in the presence of the glory of God, and Satan comes as an angel of light and makes that monkey go around look good again. But just resist him steadfast in the faith, and you will discover it for what it is. It will be the nonsense, ridiculous, crazy, wildest notion that any part of creation ever came up with. To be something different than the living God. That is the craziest, wildest, most insane notion. And it took Satan to come up with it. And today we want your eyes to be opened. Why don't you let God fill you with the spirit of truth has come to fill you with reality, truth. Why don't you just let him? Listen, I'm happy to see every one of you here today, but I'm going to be more happy to see you in heaven. I get to have an assurance that I get to see you in heaven when I can see heaven on you. So I'm going to be doing everything I know in God to make sure heaven gets poured out upon your soul today. That you'll have a contrast, that you'll be able to see a clear distinction between heaven and hell, good and evil, right and wrong, God and Satan. I pray that God the Father becomes so gloriously revealed to you, Satan, when he does transform himself into an angel of light, a messenger of truth, he stands out as ugly as he is when he's not. Amen. Can you hear me? Somebody said, how is that even possible? Because you take heed unto the word of God and you begin to walk in the spirit of truth, the Holy Ghost. And he said, I'll lead you and guide you in all truth. Father will keep us by his own might and power. Jesus said, Father, keep through thine own name those that you've given to me, that none of them will be lost on that day. And I'm telling you, that's a lot of security right there. Hallelujah. We want everybody to know here today that Father has planned and purposed to give you as a gift. Huh? To Christ Jesus. And it's kind of like the same in term Jesus gives us as a gift to the Father. Keep through thine own name, Father, those that you've given unto me. I mean, I pray today that you can begin to see the beauty of what it means to have the opportunity to be that one person that Father's called out of darkness to be a gift that he's given unto Christ Jesus. And that he, Father, woo, will keep through his own name. In other words, by his own power. We kept by the power of God through faith and the salvation ready to be revealed. And what is that revelation going to look like when we're ready to be revealed? Oh, beloved, now are we the sons of God, and yet does not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that we shall see him as he is, for we shall be like him. Hallelujah. Oh, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us that we should be called the sons of God. Beloved, now are we the sons of God. Made sons by the blood of Jesus Christ, by the power, life-giving work of the blood of Jesus Christ, by the shaping, molding hand of the Holy Ghost, made the sons of the living God. Now everyone who has this hope purifies himself even as he is pure. Hey, purify yourself. Jesus is coming. Everyone who has this hope. The hope, the beauty, the blessed promise, the riches, the grace, the glory. To be able to appear before him and see him as he is, for we shall be like him. That's almost unutterable. In fact, if the Bible didn't say it, nobody could say it. It'd be false doctrine. It'd be just too wild. It'd be too much like him, too intense. This is the gift. You can have your misery and your sorrow and your death and your shame if you want. But Father wants to give you the glory of the only begotten Son. Hallelujah. For the grace and truth. Hallelujah. He wants to beautify you today with his salvation. Hallelujah. He wants to fill you with his glorious Holy Spirit, the Spirit of holiness. Hallelujah. He wants to take you from being a child of disobedience, one who's under the prince and the power of the air, the spirit of this world that now works in the children of disobedience, and fill you with the spirit of obedience. Hallelujah. Romans 5:19 just hit me real hard. Hallelujah. He, by his obedience, came and made us the righteousness of God. You know that? He came and filled us with his righteousness so that we could be obedient children, no longer disobedient. By one man, sin and disobedience entered into the world, but through the obedience of one, many are made righteous. Have you been made righteous? Everybody just sit down. Just sit down, have a seat, get comfortable in this kind of hot atmosphere. We're believing it's going to get hotter. Everybody that's been made righteous, would you raise your hand? Now, everybody who's not been made righteous, is your opportunity to be made righteous right now. Hallelujah. Right now. As a free gift, all you have to do is recognize who Jesus is. First and fundamental thing that has to happen for you to be able to move out in God is you've got to recognize who Jesus is. Okay, it's fine. Come sit down. You got to recognize who Jesus Christ is. And it doesn't matter if you're the woman at the well who's absolutely, you talk about a person who has no right. She's been married 5 times, living with a man who's not her husband. She's not seeking God. She's not really seemingly showing any display of even being interested. She just shows up at the right time. She showed up at a God-divine appointment, given a God-divine opportunity. And all she had to do was recognize who Jesus is and the gift that he had. When people came to Jesus and they were blind or they were deaf or they were sick or they were diseased, all they had to do is they had to recognize who Jesus is. Jesus said, do you believe I'm able to do this? They had to recognize who he is. This is the only challenge that you have today, is to recognize who Jesus is. And you may be wondering in your mind, you may be thinking, who is this man, Christ Jesus? Who is this one of history? Who is this one of religion? Who is this one that so much controversy has been created over? But if you would allow something great to happen, amen. If you allow something great to happen in your life today, if you just crack the door, hallelujah, just crack the door just a little bit to the Holy Spirit, he'll come in and he will reveal Jesus to you. And it won't be an intellectual pursuit that you're trying to sort out, because I'm going to tell you right now, nobody's that intelligent. All that's going on is a bunch of smoking, smoking mirrors and sleight of hand, with everybody in the world of men trying to act like they know what this is all about, life that is, how all these things came into being. But Christ Jesus has sent to us the Holy Spirit so that we can have a revelation as real as you meeting anyone else. Huh? You don't have to intellectualize that person that you met. No one's got to create some kind of theory of how you met them. No one has to create some kind of theory of where they came from. You've had an encounter with them. You've met them. They become your friend. And that's all there is to it. Are you listening to me? Yes. And then when you meet the person that you're supposed to live with for the rest of your life, the one that you're supposed to marry, amen. Hallelujah. And that even takes it to a whole nother level. Amen. Try to figure out love. My wife and I have been married for 29 years. 30 years, forgive me, baby. Baby, you know why? The denial is this, that I don't even believe I'm that old. It's a very terrible thing for me to miss a year out of this program. But if you will notice, sometimes I say I'm 55. Sometimes I say I'm 56. sometimes I say, I'm not lying. I just can't remember. It's this funny thing that starts working on you when you start getting older. I mean, do I look 56? I mean, I don't even believe that. The beautiful thing of love. Hallelujah. God, the Holy Ghost has come to show us the beautiful thing of love. And I'm going to just give you a whole bunch of verses of scripture here this morning, okay? And I started off with Romans chapter 5 and verse 19. So if you're taking notes and you want to memorize scriptures, that's a good one to memorize. Because here's what he's done. By a free gift of salvation, by you and I recognize who he is. He comes and he gives us the gift of righteousness. He makes us a new creation. And now gives us the power and the ability to walk in obedience, to desire the things that he desires. Not to desire the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life. Not running around like a bunch of dogs sniffing the ground anymore. Come on. Amen. Hello. Are you listening to me? Hallelujah. It's good. It's good not to be a dog sniffing the ground anymore. Not to live our lives like cattle, you know, just standing around. All we do is live to eat and reproduce, you know. Forget about it. I mean, that is crazy. What existence, life is far more than all of those things. He's come and given us the ability to know him, which is above all the other, which is above all the other things and all the other opportunities. And it's through this ability to know him that all these other wonderful privileges that we now have in him begin to become a reality in our life. We want them. I mean, I'm more hungry for God than I've ever been. I've watched preachers grow older and they become all satisfied with all their knowledge and all the things they've done. My goodness gracious, I'm glad that I didn't get on that road. I'm more hungry than I've ever been for God, to know him. The given kid's coming and giving us the power that we may know him. He's come and given us an opportunity to be, you know, those who are so filled with everything that he has that we can demonstrate heaven everywhere we go so that people don't have to live in death and sin and pain and iniquity anymore. But you have to first encounter him. On a level, you have to be willing to come and take up this wonderful privilege and opportunity to know him. You got to be hungry for these things. You got to quit wavering back and forth. You got to quit having two different opinions. The diakritos, the two different minds or two different judgments from which we derive the word doubt from, and also the word wavering from, out of the Greek language. But Father, the opportunities that Father's opened up for us today. Hallelujah. 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 We want you to go over into a realm called the realms of the Holy Ghost. We want you to get out of your spirit and into him. Somebody said, you mean that can be, I've been born again, I've been born in the spirit, I've been given a new spirit, that I could actually walk under the authority and under the insight and under the mandates of my own spirit and not be yielded to the Holy Ghost? Absolutely you can. And we want you to come into a place today where you're willingly saying with your heart in desperation, Holy Ghost, come fill me. Come take hold of me. Come lead me. Come inspire me with all that is heaven. So I want you to open in this thought, I want you to open up your Bibles with me to 2 Corinthians chapter 11 and verse 4. Hallelujah. How many people follow me on Facebook? Okay, good. How many people follow me on Twitter? Good. So you kind of got the outline of what's going to go on this morning. Because that's just what happens. See, the Lord will always start stirring our hearts. Usually he stirs my heart on things about first thing in the morning on Sunday morning. If you ask me, what are you going to preach on Saturday? I would probably look at you and go, I don't know. More than likely, probably 90% of the time, maybe more than that, I don't know. But I'll tell you right now. The Lord has a word for today. Today is a brand new day. It's a day that begins all God's mercies and all God's grace and all God's opportunities for you. It's the day that you decide whether or not you're going to move on with God or whether you're going to backslide or whether you're going to stay the same. Every day. I mean, when it comes down to the point at the end of time in your life and you say, I didn't have enough opportunities. I never had an opportunity. You had how many days that you lived? Every day being an opportunity. I mean, on a grand scale, really every hour be an opportunity, but every day on a grand scale being a new opportunity. Unfortunately, the choices that you make today have huge consequences on tomorrow because more than likely you're going to repeat that same choice. You're going to become more rooted than that mindset that determined that choice in your life. And you know, last Sunday I was here and I just challenging people to think about how can you isolate what are your thoughts versus all other thoughts? Can you isolate your thoughts purely from your environment, your culture, your circumstance, those things that have been imposed upon you by your teachers and by your friends and by your peers? Can you isolate your thoughts from those things that are inspired by the realms of the demonic? Can you isolate your thoughts from all of that interplay that goes on in your imaginations every day? And the answer to that question is absolutely not. There's probably not an original thought in your head. It's all been imposed upon you by the books that you've read, the things, the stories that you've heard, the things that have been done to you. And furthermore, there is a ruthless tyrant that demands that you only think what he thinks. He's a controlling spirit that demands that you do exactly what he wants you to do, and that you he forces his ideas, his dreams upon you. There's only one way of escape out of that, dear people. You're going to have to take heed into God's word. You're going to have to understand it's a light that shines in a dark place. You know, when I think about that verse of Scripture in 1 Peter, I'm always amazed by it. I've always been amazed from the first time that I read that verse of Scripture. That here they heard the audible voice of Almighty God in the mountain. They heard God declare and say these things concerning his only begotten Son. This is my beloved Son in whom I'm well pleased. Hear ye him. And yet Peter comes along and says, we heard the audible voice, but I'm going to tell you something. There is a more certain word of prophecy. There's a more certain declaration from God that you better listen to, that you do well if you take heed unto, as to a light shining in a dark place. Because the word of God came as God moved by his spirit upon holy men of old. He breathed into him, to them, his thoughts came by inspiration. He breathed into him his desires, his thinking. And as he said to Jeremiah, put my word in your mouth. And the Father has put his word in my mouth here today to declare these things to you, to help you understand how to make a transition into the realms of the thinking of God, to cast down imaginations and thoughts. Dear people, I have found that folks do not get to move on with God because they live in layers of hurt and pain. They live in layers of unforgiveness. They live in layers of unrepented sin. They live in layers of disobedience towards God. Even they live in states of thinking that doesn't allow them, as it were, to submit to the Holy Spirit, because they literally live and make choices and decisions out of the realms of their imaginations, which is more inspired by the God of this world than anything else. And it may sound like good choices, but I've discovered that everything in the world is bad. Everything in the atmosphere is evil. All that is in the world. Jesus said to be friend of the world is to be my enemy. Somebody says, is there any good thing in the world? No. Yeah. All that is in the world, to be a friend of the world is to be my enemy. Jesus said, I'm not of the world, even as you're not of the world. I want you to understand, come out from among them, be separate. Yeah. The Lord trying to help us to understand, as long as we think this way, as long as we act this way, as long as we behave this way, as long as we're influenced this way, it's going to keep us from moving and functioning and operating in heaven, in the reality of the power of the Holy Ghost, in the life-giving power that has been imparted to us, that is supposed to flow out of us in immeasurable ways, likened unto rivers of living water flowing out of us. The power of God, the power of the name of Christ Jesus, the very life of Christ Jesus, says so be revealed and so resident in our life. The very power of the Father, his name, his glory, so resident in our life. The power of the Holy Ghost, so resident in our life. Because we is his temple. We are his temple, and we live in and we move and we have our being in him. And he lives in the midst of us with all of his fullness, he's come. But at that same time, though he has come with all of his fullness and he's done all these things, he's telling us to be continually filled with the Spirit. He's telling us to allow the word of Christ to dwell in us richly. He's talking to us about our yieldedness, our willingness to allow him to rise in the midst of us, our willingness to let him take the lead in our life. And people, imaginations and all the ideas and all the influences of this world and this culture and what you think you think, because reality of it is what you think is didn't really originate from you. So says the word of the Lord. So says God. And the only escape from it is to begin to be governed by the word of God, to think nothing except for the word of God. And so I'm going to talk to you this morning about another Jesus. I'm going to talk to you about another spirit. I'm going to talk to you about another gospel. I want you to be able to understand, you have a choice. Are you going to take the Jesus that wants you to be filled with all of heaven, or are you going to take the Jesus of a popular culture? Because they're two different Jesuses. So I want you to look here with me and see how Paul was in the same kind of issue. He's had the same kind of issue. 30 years after Jesus is dead, he's having to deal with the same kind of issues. He's having to deal with people who don't get it. But you know what? Peter didn't get it. John didn't get it. The apostles didn't get it. They were still thinking their own thoughts and doing it their own way and coming up with their own ideas and being more led by their popular opinion and by their religious beliefs. It took an encounter at Pentecost for a radical change to come where all of a sudden they said, my goodness, it's better to live in the Holy Ghost than to live in me. It's better to live in the things that the Spirit of the Lord would show us concerning Jesus, because Jesus looked at them and said, you can't get it. You have begun in the Holy Ghost, but you only got to be made perfect by him. You're going to have to learn how to depend upon him. Somebody said, how can I learn how to depend upon and have a relationship with someone I cannot see? Good question. How does someone I cannot see become real to me? First and foremost, the word of God makes him, as it were, visible and physical. Furthermore, the movings of his presence and of his glory in our life make him more real than if we saw him with our eyes and heard him with our ears. And it comes to a place that Father has said, through Jesus said, if you'll obey me, if you'll learn how to walk in obedience, and really, these things are simple obedience, I'll come manifest myself to you. And there can't be nothing more physical and visible than that. Hallelujah. It's just a decision of our will. Are we going to learn how to live by the word of God? Are we going to allow these things to be sorted out in our life? Are we going to continue on in denominationalisms? But you know what? That is a result of encounter with him. That's a result of hunger for him. Listen, hunger is something that you cultivate, people. It's not something you get overnight. Huh? And the more, and God meets us proportionally to our hunger and proportionally to our thirsting. He does. And somebody gets desperate for God and said, Lord, what does it take to break into that realm where Evan Roberts walked with you? Huh? Evan Roberts was such a terrible leader. That's what people said, because they were stuck in the spirit of man's performance. People want to go ahead and do their ceremonial things and do all their preliminaries and literally trample, walk all over the anointing and then expect God to move afterwards. This way don't move. People look at Evan Roberts and say, he's not even a leader. There needs to be somebody come in here and take over leadership here. Why? Because they'd stop singing, he'd just sit there. He'd just sit there. Quiet. The awkwardness of everybody being quiet. What are we doing now? There's no one on the platform. What are we going to do now? And the big itinerant ministers and big ministers of the big churches would come in and say, how is this thing even doing anything? There's no leadership. Somebody needs to be up there emceeing. Shut up. The great revival came because because the leader just was willing to shut up. He would sit there until a glory of God would come upon him. And when that glory hit him, the glory hit everyone else, because he was a vessel that allowed the rivers of God to flow through him. And when the rivers of God are flowing through you, the dimension by which the rivers of God flow through me is the dimensions by which I can communicate the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. But it's the dimension by which people can begin, hallelujah, to be touched with the glory of heaven. And I'm desperate for more. I don't want to misrepresent God. I want people just to be stuck in a little manifestation of Jesus. Just because I haven't chose to follow God all the way, I haven't chose to live by his word in the face of every doubt and imagination that tries to instruct me and tell me different, I'm willing to do whatever it takes to say nothing until he speaks. Whew. People, I'm telling you right now, Father's watching over his word to perform it, and he's hastening a day right now in which he's going to show forth the glory of his sons. There's a precious fruit of the earth. Father's filled my mouth with this word. And about, I think it was 4 or 5 months ago, maybe a little bit longer. Was it a little bit longer? 6 months ago, April. Lord filled my mouth with this word and spoke to me and told me I was going to start ministering it all over the United States of America. It was about 6 months ago, 7 months ago. And now that's all those things are starting to line up. And, you know, and I pray that I don't go everywhere seeing the power of God move and somebody in this place misses out on an opportunity to receive that which God is saying from heaven. Where's his heartbeat? People talk about, well, this gospel of the kingdom must be preached in all the world as a witness to all the nations, and the end shall come. That's true, but there's something else. He said, dearly beloved, have patience in the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, because he's waiting for the precious fruit of the earth. Father's waiting for the precious fruit of the earth, James 5:7. He's waiting for the precious fruit of the earth. He's waiting for something that looks like what Paul described and discovered in Galatians 1:17. The Father chose to reveal his Son in him. That suddenly there becomes a relationship, hallelujah, that we begin to have with a Father that is exactly like the express image, exactly like the one that Jesus demonstrated. I'm telling you, I live for that day. I was born for that day. I breathe for that day. You know, I'm telling you, this is it. This is it. Somebody, I'm going to get to this, but I just got to tell you a couple of stories because I'm just so prompted by the Holy Ghost to do so, because it's just so fundamental to what I'm going to actually be saying here in a few minutes. We were in a nation, we were out in the boondocks in a nation, and there was 10, 15,000 people there. It was radical. And they started doing their cultural thing. The girls got up and started dancing. They were doing their songs and whatnot, and I got angry. And I said, you shut this thing down right now, or I'm out of here. I didn't come here to watch you move your body around. Okay? Now, here's the mean, controlling preacher who doesn't know how to walk in love. Huh? Because they're trampling all over the anointing. Right. Because I'm desiring the manifest presence of Jesus. I'm desiring the Holy Ghost to have full control. I'm desiring the sacredness of his realm. They want to do their cultural thing. I said, I don't need your cultural thing. They said, all these people are here because of the cultural thing. I'm not here for the cultural thing. God brought them here. I ain't come here for you. Have you ever had a crowd this big? Well, no. Well, guess what? Surprise. Surprise, surprise, surprise. Guess what? This is what God has done. Out. You're out of here. You're not on the platform anymore. Or I'm gone. You choose. They decided to leave. 100% of the people, 100% of the Hindus came rushing to the platform. I mean, they rushed to the platform to give their life to Jesus. 100%. Not 99%. 100%. All the people came. It was the day that I described where I felt like Jesus, where I got myself in trouble and said, everybody who wants a touch from the Lord. After they responded to salvation, I went out in the middle of the crowd and I got trampled. I almost got trampled. I got squeezed on. And then the military police guys came in and broke up the crowd, and they became my deacons and my ushers that day, lined up everybody, made sure that I didn't miss praying for anyone. Then they all got in line to be prayed for too, to accept Jesus and to be healed of their various different diseases and ailments. Why? 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 Because I would not tolerate one thing that I saw, that I had enough discernment to recognize that's contrary to the Holy Ghost, that will grieve him, that will shut him down. Hey, you listen to me. So I did it out of a zeal, not out of a love, a zeal for his house. We went to southern Nepal, went to another place in, 2013. So, and I'm going to just tell you, that day, I think, how many days were we there? 2 or 3 days in that town in Kawasuti. Yeah. 3 days. Miracles, signs, and wonders. People talk about it this day where, I mean, there was 2,000 people, leaders, 2,000 leaders, in the morning meetings, fell out under the power of God and laid in the hot, baking sun. It was over 110 degrees, laid in the hot, baking sun for well over an hour under the power of God. No sweat, nothing. Supernatural thing. Signs and wonders. So we were invited to go to this other place. I didn't really want to go. I didn't feel that this was what the Lord wanted to do. It was, you know, in his strategic plan, it was what I was supposed to do, but I was compelled to do it. And I didn't want to go because I felt in my spirit religion, the opposing force of religion, they're going to oppose. The Christians that are there will oppose the anointing. I felt in my spirit. And then I went. Then I got there and I saw them doing their thing. You were there. I said, well, I'm not gonna say nothing. I'm gonna be the nice guy. I'm not gonna say nothing. Father, look at this nonsense. See, in my spirit, I'm seeing and knowing all the violation, they're trampling all over the Holy Ghost, they're trampling all over the anointing, and then they want the power of God to move. I just said, no, I'm not saying nothing. I'm tired. Say nothing. I just sat there. But then a lot of people responded to the altar call. Very few. We had a few miracles. Why? They trampled all over the anointing, and I sat by and let them. I don't usually do that. I mean, the last night we had some pretty incredible things happen. I just released Elizabeth on them. I said, Elizabeth, go get them. She went laying hands on everybody. Fire of God started falling on the people, the religious people there. It was great. I'm tired. Lord, you're going to have to step in and do it. He's not going to step in and do it. He's saying, you do it. I've assigned you to do it. Huh? Now, this is where it's challenging for you, because you don't like the mean, controlling preacher. It's telling you, you're trampling all over the anointing. You're doing it wrong. You've got to stop that, because if you don't stop it, you're never going to go into a deeper flow. And then you get in that imagination mindset, that defensive mindset, that pride of life mindset. Huh? And then you never get to be the revival church that God wants you to be. You never get to be the person or the individual that is a carrier of a greater dimension of His glory. Praise God you're saved, sweetheart. Bless your baby bottom. No, I'm saying it in an affectionate way. You hear me? Because it's just, you know, babies kind of thing. But you have to understand there has to be a transition. There has to be a transition. Where you put away childish things, where you begin to understand what Father is doing and what Father's business is all about. And so today, you know, I'm not going to just talk about to people who maybe not know the Lord Jesus, or maybe just have a new beginning in Christ Jesus, and Father would say to you, well done, right where you're at. I'm going to talk to the people who've been sitting around a long time and haven't understood how to move into the power and the glory of heaven. How to ultimately be prepared and ready to be used by God, prepared unto every good work. We understand how that God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good, the good works, healing all who are oppressed of the devil. Praise God. Father's purpose that you and I do the same thing. Yes. And so this gets me in to now 2 Corinthians chapter 11. I want you to understand, you can't trample all over the anointing in your morning, in your day, and expect the power of God to be revealed in your life. Amen. Listen to me. I'm going to tell you, listen here, listen. During the days of Daniel, Satan had an authority over the people of Israel and over Daniel. So when God wanted to bring the provision of heaven, the powers of darkness were able to stand there and say, you cannot bring it. They were able to resist God. God had to do, as it were, almost a warfare, God doing warfare. God had to do warfare to be able to bring to Daniel the word that he wanted to deliver to him. When you allow sin in your life, Satan has the same right. He has an authority because you come under his power through sin. Praise God that the blood of Jesus Christ will wash the sin away, and we can repent and we can move forward with God right then and there. But he's going to come back, and he's going to come back, and he's going to come back, until ultimately you and I have stood up by the authority of the name of Jesus and the word of God and said, you can't have no rights here. There are these things that hinder people. I'll tell you right now, your prayers be hindered right, left, and center. He wants to answer everything that you ask him. He's ordained for you to ask, and he will answer. But if you don't even dwell with your wives according to knowledge, your prayers will be hindered. He won't answer your prayer. I can go on and on and on and on about hindering spirits and hindering things that take place in our life because of disobedience, because we won't do it God's way. We're not willing to be conformed to his nature, to his character, to his demeanor, to his disposition, to his behavior. If we're willing to, first and foremost, we got the best, most glorious, majestic behavior on the planet. And second of all, we got a wide open heart to the flow of heaven. And now the Father wants to give to us, nothing can hold back from us. There's no powers of darkness saying, no, he's still playing under my imagination. He's still playing under my mindset. He's still playing under my thinking. He's still walking in disobedience to you. He won't do it your way. Father's eyes are upon the righteous, but his face is against them to do evil. Don't you tell me that there aren't things that won't hinder you and keep you back, that will keep you back from receiving all that Father has freely given. I want us to get sober and wake up, become fit and equipped for the battle, to be able to stand against all the wiles of the enemy, so that you and I can walk untouched, unscathed, unhindered by anything that belongs to hell. I hate hell. I hate the devil. You should hate hell too. Much torment and ugly things that are going on in that. You want to see what's coming out of hell? Just look at the 200 million horsemen that come up out of hell during the tribulation. I mean, that's just bad. That's probably the better part of it. Those are the nice looking guys. Jesus, help us. Father wants us to be filled with the glory of heaven. Men get to make a choice. It's heaven or hell. It's right or wrong. Somebody said, how do you know? If there's perfect, first of all, the Word of God describes it to us with many infallible proofs. Many infallible proofs. Yeah, you know why? I'm going to tell you right now, the imaginations of man's heart is such as this. You can just walk through the Red Sea having it been parted by the power of God and see all of Pharaoh's army drowned in it and then doubt it happened. You hear me? And then doubt it happened. Because that's exactly where Israel's at. I'm going to tell you right now, you and I, all of us, a bunch of lookalikes and act-alikes and think-alikes. Father's given us the power to clean escape from all those, clean escape all those influences. And now only walk under the power. The power. That's more than influence. The power. The sovereign power of the Holy Ghost. Come on, man. What do you want? Demons or heaven? I mean, come on. You want the Holy Ghost? Or do you want evil spirits? I mean, come on. Understand the rules of it. Understand the laws, the spiritual laws of life of it. And live. Recognize who Jesus is and the gift he's got. Recognize who he is. And you're going to live the abundant life. Hallelujah. Somebody said, oh, the way of the Christian life is hard. I don't know anything about that. The way of the transgressor is hard. Way of God's people, not hard. It's bliss. It's abundant life. It's fullness of life. It's joy unspeakable life. It's peace that passes understanding life. Come on, give me a break. It's love beyond all thinking and knowledge life. Hallelujah. And the kingdom of God is righteousness, joy, and peace in the Holy Ghost. Five hand claps, one hand raised, and three grins. Just trying to keep statistics going in terms of the total reaction to the good word of God. Hallelujah. I'm telling you right now, all who hear the joyful sound, all who know the joyful sound, come on. Ruth Anna gave a word of prophecy, a word of exhortation on Wednesday night. It's been burning my heart ever since. And when she began to be proclaimed by the Spirit, what ails your praise? What ails your thanksgiving? What aileth your rejoicing? Am I not glorious enough? Am I not good enough? Am I not wonderful enough? Man, I'm telling you right now, I just got blasted by it. I said, oh God, yes. I mean, I'm going to take it up another notch. You are wonderful enough. You are glorious enough. I mean, reality of it is, I mean, if I didn't understand how to enter into his presence, if I didn't feel the overwhelming presence of God, I might be bored with the thing too. If I was just basically interacting with an imaginary figure that I never felt hurt or, that might be pretty bad. But that's not what's going on in my life. That's not the gospel I have received, the spirit I received, or the Jesus I have received.
Amen.
That's not the move of the Spirit of the living God that lives on the inside of me, that looks over across the landscape of humanity and realizes that there's coming a shower from heaven that no man will be untouched by, a glory from heaven, a tsunami of his presence, a great outpouring of the power of God that all men will be shaken by. This is true. This is what we live for. This is what we see. Hallelujah. It's what Papa prepares us for in every good work. Hallelujah. I mean, you know, people think they get too old. Man, you're never too old to obey God and to start agreeing with God. You know, Smith Wigglesworth started agreeing with God at an older age. All he could do was write his name. Come on. And his wife taught him how to do that. Goodness gracious. He couldn't read and write. And all of a sudden, God gave him the power to read the Word of God, and he memorized the whole thing. The New Testament. He memorized the New Testament. And look what God did through him. He said he don't want anything else but the Word of God and the Spirit of God. He said, I don't want nothing else but the Word of God and the Spirit of God. It really comes down to what my dear friend Roger Teal, God's used him as a prophet in his life. He's 74 years old. 74 years old now. Roger, if you're watching, we love you with all of our hearts. I'm sure you're preaching somewhere. But
You know, just say it makes it real simple. Read your Bible, say your prayers, be good. It's true. And I mean, read your Bible in the sense of actually interacting with the Word of God and understanding what God has to say and recognizing that it's the ways of life. And if you do it, you will live. And what it means to be living is to be filled with a mighty wind of His presence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Prayer, more than just now lay me down to sleep. I pray thee, Lord, my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray thee, Lord, my soul to take. It's far more than all of that. It's a prayer where you begin to interact with the Almighty, where you speak to Him and He speaks back. Hallelujah. It's so easy to hear the voice of God. I hear the voice of God all the time. Hallelujah. So just check out my Facebook and Twitter. I'm constantly hearing God speak things right out of the realms of heaven. Hallelujah. That's one of the wonderful things I love about prayer. I hear His voice with greater clarity. You grow into that. You build that. You start praying, and you expect a McDonald's hamburger response from God. You know, you fast service. Within 3 minutes, you expect to be able to have all the things that the Word of God has declared, and otherwise you're going to give up and faint. You just might as well go ahead and give up and faint right now. Yes. That's not the way it works. Hallelujah. God's not raising a bunch of brats. I mean, He's raising highly disciplined people of the Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who know how to walk with Him. The more you obey, the more you get to see it, just the way it works. Praise God. You obey a little bit, God works a miracle. Call upon the name of Jesus, He transforms your life. What a miracle. Huh? What a, hallelujah. What a great event a little bit of obedience will get you into. Paul said, these guys transform themselves into angels, and messengers of God, coming to you, wolves in sheep clothing, speaking their own nonsense. No wonder, not too hard to even conceptualize, because Satan himself is transformed into a messenger of light. He says, you're willing to bear with them. You're willing to listen to them. They preach in another Jesus, and they preach in another spirit, and they're preaching by another spirit, and they're preaching another gospel. But here, I'm jealous over you. I'm jealous over you. I've espoused you as a chaste virgin in God, and I'm standing here with a protective love trying to tell you what's of God and what's not of God, what's of the anointing, what's not of the anointing, and now you won't even listen to me. You say, he's contemptible. Well, that's the way it works with. That's the way it works. God's prophets, God's people, just they're going to be persecuted. You want to be a prophet, preacher, minister, you're going to be persecuted. You might as well get used to it. And that's why you got to learn how to stand before the presence of the Lord, because the only opinion that even matters to you is God's. You don't even care anymore. It's like, I got God's approval. Thank you. I don't care what anybody says. I got God's approval. It doesn't matter. And so that's what sets the tone for this verse of Scripture here. In 2 Corinthians. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you that you're going to use Mike in a mighty, amen, glorious, yes, way. I thank you, Father, for the mantle of the Holy Ghost upon him. Yes. Get ready, man. Hallelujah. 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 I praise God. I can always count on Mike being excited about the things of the Spirit. You know, Paul opens up. He says, I would that you bear with me in my folly. You know what his folly is? A jealous motherly love. That's his folly. I got that. A jealous motherly love that says, wait a minute, who are you talking to now? What are you believing in? What are you saying now? What are you doing now? Stop that right now. That is not God. And people don't like it. I don't like people telling me what to do. We grown up now. We don't need you no more. You started this church, but we grown up now. We want a diversity of ministry. We don't want to be all inbred. No, it's because Jay comes up with some wild ideas, I'll tell you. We want a little bit broader form of ministry than what you're bringing to us. He says, for I am jealous of you with godly jealousy. Huh? This is what God puts in preachers' hearts. You find a man of God who's anointed of the Spirit of God, and he's jealous over God's people with a godly jealousy. God is a jealous God. Yes. Yes. He don't like any foul spirits come messing with his people. And worse than that, he doesn't like his people romancing with some foul, slew-footed, you know, demonic power and calling it good. It's like, what? I've just given you everything that pertains to life and godliness, and you got to go over and kiss on that thing? You got to go over and acknowledge that thing? You got to go over and sacrifice your life and your time for those things? It's as bad as offering incense upon the rooftops, huh? And prayers to the gods of men. Think about it. Paul says, I have espoused you to one husband, not two. Looky here. You're supposed to be virtuous. I see you becoming unvirtuous. I see you mixing things. I see you going after other things. I want to straighten you out. I want you to understand what spirit you are of, what Christ you are of, what gospel you are of. And if there's ever a message that needs to challenge the hearts of the people today, it is this message. Prove that you are in Christ Jesus. Otherwise, you just reprobate. If you can't prove it, you reprobate. That's powerful words Paul preached powerful words to the church of Corinth, trying to straighten them out from their crooked influences. But he says, but I fear lest any of you by any means, he says, I fear lest by any means as the serpent beguiled Eve. How did the serpent beguile Eve? Using the word of God and twisting it. Go back and read it, Genesis chapter 3, verses 1 through 3. Go back and read it. Huh? No, we're not all going to heaven. Jesus Christ is the truth, the way, the life. He's the door. No man can come unto the Father but him, but by him. And the entrance into the kingdom of God is very narrow because he is the only way. He said all others are liars and thieves and robbers, and so are anybody who trusts in them. That's what Jesus said. He was not a pluralistic guy who had his arms wide open in an eclectic way to embrace all various different religions and expressions. He said they lies, they falsehoods. Listen to me. People just want to just have their word. Oh, the word of God's not true. It's not accurate. Yeah, it's true and it's accurate. God watches over his word to perform it. And historically, it's accurate. And statistically, with all the, you take all the extant manuscripts, and statistically, it's accurate. Hallelujah. Listen to me here. Because there's a lot of lies, and Satan's running in here and saying, well, there are many interpretations. No, there is not many interpretations. How many mothers did Jesus have? How many fathers did he have? Two. One real father, one stepfather. Right. Trick question. How many stones was in Goliath's hands?
None.
Good. How many was in David's hands? Five. Very good. That's not open for interpretation. Now, if it was open for interpretation, you could say that spiritually, maybe Goliath had five stones in his hand. But that's nonsense. It steals the word of God. All these spiritualizations, all these mixtures that you can see, it's obvious there's only one plot behind it, is to steal what really is there from the hearts of men so that they do not know how to walk with God. And as a result, we left sterile and barren and lifeless and powerless. Sometimes somebody get aggravated.
Amen.
It's time somebody start moving something around over here. Say, listen, I'm telling you right now, I don't care about things in the earth. I care about engaging in the spiritual realm. And the weapons of my warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God. And I'm going to be filled with the strength of the Lord and the power of his might. Because I wrestle not against flesh and blood. I'm taking the whole armor of God. I'm going to bring down spiritual wickedness. I'm going to deal with it. I'm going to trample it to the ground. I'm going to tread over scorpions and serpents and over all the power of the enemy. I'm going to deal with Satan as Christ Jesus dealt with him. He was manifested to destroy him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
To destroy his works specifically. Hallelujah. Come on, man. I can feel it. I can hear some of you saying, I can feel some of you moving around the rumblings of your armor, as it were. Hey, listen, let us out of here. We're ready to go get it done.
Yeah.
But the reality of it is so much of it we get done right here. There's something about the assembly of God's people. There's something about the gathering together unto him. There's something about the force and the power of the church and the agreement that is there in the midst of his church where people are gathered in his name.
Yeah.
Something going on here. You want to make sure that you always say, and all the way through the process, yes, 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 yes. Never no, because all that's coming out of your imagination.
Yeah.
that is strongly influenced, powerfully influenced by the demonic realm, because that's the way he impacts us with the fiery darts. But a shield of faith, which comes to us by the word of God, will stop all that. Hallelujah. And then on top of that, with a helmet of salvation, my goodness, it just can't penetrate. You good? Hallelujah. I just come right back to the word. I understand how to engage in the realms of my mind and my thinking to only believe and submit myself to the knowledge of Jesus Christ. And it's a battle. And it has been a battle. But I'm going to tell you right now, the more you do it, the less of a battle it is, the more the natural flow of the Holy Ghost is such that you govern, ruled, and led by the Holy Spirit, by the Word of God, where you can literally come to a place in Christ Jesus where you determine every thought that will be in your mind. Amen. Think about it. Ooh, yeah, that's power. Where the imaginations and the lies of Satan, they get to exist for maybe a microsecond. They get to exist for just a little short time. The power of God, poof, moves. Destroys it. Huh? I just turn the light right towards it. Where's that thought? Knock it completely out. The light of His Word. Hallelujah. Ha! The power of His name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Verse 4. He says, for if he that comes preaches another Jesus than we have preached, and if you receive it, or if you receive another spirit which ye have not received, or another gospel which ye have not received, why do you suffer that person, or why do you allow that person? You're willing to bear with them. You're willing to continue on and just go with them in what they've got to describe to you and got to share with you, and you consider it, but you can't bear with me, and I'm trying to sort out for you what's lie and what's truth. I'm trying to show you where the things that Satan would come with the Word of God in a subtle way and deceive your heart and spoil you and keep you from moving forward and that which Christ Jesus purchased you to be. I can't go through every dimension of all that was said by those in that Paul highlights in the New Testament, and that Jesus highlights in the New Testament that describes another Jesus. Nor can I have time today to go through and give you an example of all those who are preaching, even on television, on Christian channels and churches across the land, all in the name of Jesus, preaching another Jesus. I can't go through and itemize all the things that declare and specifically show and reveal another spirit and another gospel. But I'm going to hit just a little bit on another spirit, because I tell you, there's so much that is revealed with respect to another spirit. And I want you to just look at this with me, just real quickly. I want you to look with me in 1 Corinthians chapter 2. In verse 12, and I want you to be equipped. I want you to be on guard, because the spirit of this world is trying to influence you and come subtly disguised as though it's all right with God. God understands. It's okay with Him. You should not surely die, for God does know. It's just spiritual. You won't really die. That's not what He really meant. After all, I don't know what day it was. Maybe it was the second day of creation. This is the second day of creation. After all, this is the 21st century. Things have developed since He last said something. You expect us to live under the order of the culture of the first century? This is the 21st century. We've advanced. We know more. No, God's way off in the future. He's way off in the future. I know, I don't think you should run around, you know, in robes and sandals. And that has nothing to do with the way you dress. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
It has to do with the way you live and act and behave and think. Huh? It has to do with the way you interact with God the Holy Ghost, or you interact with the evil spirits. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. I'm going to try to do this real quickly. I know some of you are real hot. I pray you get hotter. I pray the fire of God comes on you and starts burning on you, that you just, in such a way that you just jump up and start running like somebody on fire. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Father, for the energizing presence of the Holy Ghost. Yeah. Woo. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 says, Paul says, now you have not received the spirit of the world. Ah, another spirit. Because there's only going to be one or two spirits. And he's dealing with another spirit that's come to preach another Jesus. Another spirit will always preach another Jesus, and always will ultimately, then by default, is preaching another gospel. Yeah. You've not received the spirit of the world. Look at here. But you receive the spirit which is of God.
Amen.
Even, so think about this. That we might freely know the things that are freely, given to us by God. I have God's spirit. There needs to be an evidence of that. And Father wants to produce an evidence of it. So let's just go ahead real quickly, because if I start talking too much about it, you're going to be here all day. So go quickly, Romans chapter 8, 15. Romans 8, 15. You might want to jot these down. That way you can go listen, look at them a little bit more, and let God deal with you a little bit more on these things. The spirit, when Paul says in Romans 8:15, you've not received the spirit of bondage, again to fear. People live under every different form of fear that produces all kinds of intimidation. Doubt comes out of the realms of fear. But you've received the spirit of sonship, whereby you say, God is my daddy, my papa. He's my daddy. Ami is the closest way to saying daddy, is the most intimate kind of talk concerning that this is the one I came from. This is my dad. This is my parent. See, another spirit. Are you speaking into the spirit of that belongs to God? Is it God's spirit that is speaking? God's spirit is going to be speaking the same things that he's always spoke. It's going to be the same word. It's going to be the same call. It's going to result in the same fashion of men's heart. Are you speaking out of the spirit of sonship? Are you speaking of the spirit of the world? Is there worldliness there? Is it giving you an opportunity to continue on in sin that you're still okay, not living a consecrated life? It's another spirit. It's another Jesus. Because I think that if I can grab a hold of you here this morning and have you understand that the spirit is pivotal as to whether in the manifestation of the spirit, where it's coming from in the realm of the spirit is pivotal to proving whether it's from Jesus. It is of Jesus. It is the Jesus or another Jesus. It is the Jesus that died for us at Calvary's cross and rose again, sent up on high. Or if it's another gospel, the one that Paul said, if you hear anything else, if somebody else comes and preaches another gospel, says, let them be a curse. Even if an angel preaches something different. If all of a sudden an angel, 40 foot tall, standing in here, right now manifests, says, Spitzberger doesn't know what he's talking about, listen to me. Jesus was only a prophet. Or Spitzberger doesn't know what he's talking about. Listen to me. Jesus died for your sin that you may continue in sin. Don't worry about it anymore. It's all okay. We're going to be actually partying in heaven. We just bought a couple more kegs. So everybody can get real drunk on the first day. And we're going to have some lines of cocaine for you to sniff there too. Whatever. Hey. Ah. It's okay. Go ahead. Continue on the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life. It's in heaven too. We've all changed. God's changed. He discovered one day that he was angry, and he just decided he wouldn't be angry anymore about sin, so he basically made it swear sin was okay. He did a work, a righteous work, that his judgments may be annulled. Don't say amen yet. He did a righteous work that his judgments may be annulled. Hello? Annulled. That his judgments may be annulled. It's being taught right now. Right now. At this very moment. At this very moment. In the biggest churches in the land. That his judgments may be done away with and annulled. That there should be no more judgment executed against sin. The final judgment executed against sin was in Christ Jesus. Everybody else is fine. Through his righteousness and through his obedience, everybody's been made obedient regardless. He has done a work to where that even though Adam's impact of sin upon you was so great, now his righteousness, his righteous impact is upon you is so great. Even as you did not sin after the manner of sin that Adam sinned, so even so, you haven't done the righteousness after the manner of Jesus' righteousness. But just as you were made sinful through Adam's sin, you're now made righteous through Adam's through Jesus' righteousness, no matter what you do. No. For he's done a work through Christ Jesus to annul his judgment. Sin unto Jesus. Because why? I'm not perfect by now. I don't care how many people twist the word and make it fit their own ideas and fashion after their own thinking. It doesn't matter what you do, you're always going to be saved. Because it comes right out of the same thing, it comes right out of the same root. It's another branch from the same root. You hear me? Once you're saved, you're always saved. Don't matter what you do. You live like the devil, you're going to live in hell. You're going to go to hell. You practice sin, you're not saved. Jesus said it. John said it. Paul said it. Peter said it. I'm saying it. Now you say something different, you're on your own. I'm said in the company of that which the word of God declared. But listen, back to the whole point. Is it the spirit of the world? Is it the spirit of the world or is it the spirit of God? God's spirit doesn't change. It's what you're hearing and what you're being called to do. Is it producing within you the spirit of God, which produces his way, his life, his thinking? Or is it producing within you something else, an accommodation, an acceptance, a justification of the state of the world and the spirit of the world and sin and iniquity? It's another spirit. This is the spirit of sonship, which is ultimately to be conformed in every way to the image of Christ Jesus, who is the Son. Paul said to Timothy, what is it? Is it 2 Timothy chapter 1? I believe it's like verse 9. Somebody help me there. He said, you've not received the spirit of fear. Huh? Listen to me, dear people. But you've received... Verse 7. 2 Timothy 1:7. But you receive the spirit of power. You receive the spirit of power, the ability to overcome the world. Receive the spirit of love. Dear people, you've got to understand through these things also what you're allowing to influence you. Because there are many spirits. There's spirits that operate through the spirit of man. There's spirits that operate just in the atmosphere of the world. You got to understand, are you being influenced by the spirit of the world? Are you being the spirit of the world is a true, living, tangible spirit, Ephesians 2:2. Describes to us that spirit of the world. Or are you being influenced by the spirit of God in your thinking, in your attitudes, in your behavior? Are you being influenced by the spirit of fear or by the spirit of sonship? What is it? What's going on? What are the dynamics in your life? And how much does the spirit of fear and how much does the spirit of bondage and how much does the spirit of the world meet a forcible resistance when you encounter it? What comes out of the realms of the kingdom of God is love and joy. What comes out of the realms of the kingdom of God is righteousness, joy, and peace in the Holy Ghost, Romans 14:17. What comes out of the realms of the Holy Ghost is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, temperance, meekness. Come on.
Amen.
Godliness, goodness, all these wonderful things. A purity of heart. You had to think about it. Have I received the spirit of holiness or the spirit of filthiness? Am I allowing a filthy spirit to influence me or am I allowing the spirit of holiness to govern me? In other words, am I allowing the spirit of filthiness to govern me, to influence me, to have power over me, or am I allowing the spirit of holiness? Jesus was proven to be the Son of God by the spirit of holiness. Have you read it? What is that? Romans 1:4, by the spirit of holiness. 2 Corinthians chapter 7, 1. What does it say? Dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves, purify ourselves, keep ourselves, not allow. The spirit of this world Let us perfect holiness in the fear of God. Let us cleanse ourselves from all the filthiness of the flesh. Hallelujah. What spirit are you of? There's a spirit of Jesus, spirit of Christ. This scripture just tells us, be endued with the spirit of Christ, or put on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lust. That's what the Lord says. That's what he says to us. Hello. We can do that. It's available.
Yes, it is.
If you walk in the spirit, you should not fulfill the lust of the flesh. You have to understand, what spirit am I allowing to influence me? Because Satan can take death and make it look like you want it more than you can to have it. That's you can't right. resist it. I got to have it. God understands I got to have some more death. He knows we got to do death more or less every day. We got to have our dose of death or we can't live.
Jesus, help us.
I can't help it. I got to have me some demon power. I got to have some influence of evil spirit. It's like coffee.
No, it's nonsense. It's iniquity. It's a deception. It's craziness. What spirit are you of? Huh? Are you moving in another spirit? Are you receiving from another spirit, whether it's coming out of the pulpit or coming out of the realms of your thoughts or the realms of the community that you're hanging out with? Have you been called out of darkness into his marvelous light? If you have, there's going to be a bubble up on the inside of you that springs forth the praises of him. Hallelujah. Right to you, because there's a river flowing. The spirit of the Lord God's on the inside of me. I'm willing to let him continually fill me. He's here and resident and present, but unless I understand how to yield my members to him, I'm not going to be filled with the Spirit continually. And it has a result, spiritual songs and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart unto God, giving thanks always for all things. Hallelujah. Hey, my praise isn't under some kind of ailment, it's not diseased, it's not sick and weak and lying on the bed and can't move. What aileth thy praise? What aileth your thanksgiving? What aileth your joy? Is the kingdom of God under the influence of heaven. That was Jesus Christ wants to pour out upon us. He wants to fill us with heaven.
Yeah.
Well, brother, how much heaven would he like to fill us with? He wants to fill us with so much heaven. It gushes out of us like rivers. Not like some little water hose. No. Not like some fire hose. No. Not like some little stream. Oh, look, let the stream is flowing. Oh, let's measure it. Oh, it's going about 34 gallons a minute. That's a pretty good stream. I've seen some springs where it's 2,000 gallons a minute. That is powerful. Powerful. I know a place where a big river, the John Day River, starts, and it starts as a spring that's a little bit over, I think it's like 4,000 or 5,000 gallons a minute. But by the time you get down the mountain, it's a river that's 30 foot wide. It's not that deep. It's only about 5-6 foot deep, but it's about 30 foot wide, and flows for long ways because other springs converge upon it. That's powerful. The Lord said, "I got rivers for you. I got rivers." Habasateri. Hallelujah. Right now, if you go to Victoria Falls in Livingston, Zambia, the Victoria Falls isn't that impressive. And that's just one river, by the way. It's not that impressive. It's just got one, nice waterfall. It's about 10 foot wide. When Ann and I were there back in, what was it, May? When we were there in May, it was as wide as the canyon. What is that? It's like a half a mile wide, and it is busting loose, and the spray is spraying out for a quarter of a mile. You're getting drenched. You're getting soaked. I'm standing there looking at it and saying to Anna, I said, more than, that's what's coming out of me and more. God, the Holy Ghost is here today. God the Father is here in my life today. God the Holy Ghost is here. I'm His temple. People, you got to understand, there is a proper application of that which belongs to the Spirit of God in our life, who is always declaring the Word of God, not a new original thought. The Word of God that is forever settled in heaven, which He watches over to hasten it, to perform it. And you begin to speak the Word of God. God says to me all the time, like He says to Jeremiah, "What do you see, son of man?" I say, "I see the Father living in me. Oh, whatsoever my word to perform it." Hallelujah. "You have seen well." You tell me that the Word of God which we preach and which we read isn't as much of a viable and impactful vision as what Jeremiah saw that day with a pot overturned facing the north. I tell you, it's living. It's powerful. It'll change you. It will take every part of your life and make it every part that He Himself has established for us to be in Christ Jesus. You have to speak. God didn't meditate everything into existence. Praise God for the communication of the words, the going forth of the preaching of the Word of God, that men's life can be changed. Huh? God didn't say, "Thinking about the Word changes you." He said, "Confessing the Word." Yeah. Hallelujah. People are going to have to get a mouth and a voice that comes by the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God. It's not influenced by the spirit of the world. It's not influenced by the spirit of bondage. It's not influenced by the spirit of fear. The Spirit of God that comes right out of a realm spoken by a spirit of the Son, who's bold and strong and powerful and full of the Spirit of power and love. Hallelujah. Who knows and believes the love that God has for them. Today I stand here knowing and believing the love that God has for me. God, He is love. Here is how my love is made perfect, and perfect love casts out all fear. Here's how my love is made perfect. Here's where I have boldness right now to command the devil to loose his hold. This is the fast that God has chosen, that I go and set the oppressed free. Hallelujah. And a big part of that is declaring the Word of God as He said it, making a difference between the holy and the unholy, the profane and that which is clean. Amen. That which belongs to God and that which belongs to Satan. There has to be a clear dividing line, a clear evidence and separation between the two of light and darkness, truth and lie. Hallelujah. Tora Masiteya. And if I'm willing to do that, I'm telling you, Father watches over His Word. He's anxious to deliver it. He's anxious to hasten to bring forth the manifested sons. He's anxious to hasten and bring forth the precious fruit of the earth, in other words. He's anxious and hastens to see His people rise up and let the oppressed go free and break off every yoke. Yes. Hallelujah. The yoke of sickness and disease, I can't tolerate it. I got to get my hands over there. I got to speak some word of life. Hallelujah. Just some word. I mean, all I said to the first time person the other day, yesterday, we were all driving down the road. I just simply said, "Well, I just got to be led by the Lord." As soon as I said that, she just started crying. "What'd you say?" "Well, I'm sobbing." By the time she said, "I'm just trying to do some business with her." By the time we got finished with the conversation, she just had to hang up. She was just sobbing. Huh? The Spirit of the Lord's all over us. The Spirit of the Lord, hallelujah, is in our words, on a telephone. Just said a couple of simple little things. Power of God. I could feel the power of God. First of all, I feel the power of God on me. I feel the anointing on me. I'm first partaker of it. It's a wonderful thing about being able to minister to other people. You first partaker of it. Hallelujah. Let God raise you up. Let God begin to form you and shape you and make you everything that He's purposed for you to be. Fill you with heaven. Hallelujah. Fill you with the goodness of heaven. I'm telling you, there's nothing that can match the joy that He brings. There's nothing that can match the love that He brings. There's nothing that can match the peace that He brings. There's nothing that can match the goodness that He brings. Just say goodbye to religion. Get delivered from denominationalism, as one dear brother put it. Get delivered from all your other, isms and beliefs. Understand how to stand up against the things that would defy the word and try to change Jesus into another Jesus and make you to be different than what he's purposed you to be and purchased you to be. Hallelujah. I'm telling you right now, you don't have to be coming across some kind of, you know, obnoxious to people. I tell you, let in the Spirit of the living God, let in the Spirit of the Son, let the Spirit of power and love, let the Spirit of his glory begin to flow out of you. People bow. Their hearts are sliced in two. Huh? Harabasedeya pekina sai. Lorena mandasedeya pikeasha. Haramamata. To speak the truth in love is a wonderful and a beautiful thing. Hallelujah. And that's only possible by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Se tekere masande peyatusha. Ebende labasteya. What do you want? You want the Jesus that demanded that you be changed and filled with heaven? Or do you want the Jesus of popular culture and opinion? Huh? Some people want the Jesus of popular culture and opinion, because then they don't have to have any change at all. They can go on just being what they've been. Anybody who wants to go on being what they've been have never come out of darkness, because they've never seen the death and the lifelessness and the sorrow and the sadness and the demonic stronghold and the tyranny of Satan that has oppressed them and possessed them. Huh? Anybody who's had an encounter with the living God, the Christ Jesus, they want the change that he's demanded, the change in which we are filled with heaven. He wants us to be filled with heaven. God wants you to be filled with every good thing. Hallelujah. He wants you to be filled with everything that pertains to life and godliness. Hallelujah. Yeah. He wants to give you every good and perfect gift. Hallelujah. He wants to provide for you according to his riches and glory. Hallelujah. He wants to strengthen you so that you'll be strengthened with all his power and with all of his might. He wants to bless you with all the riches of heaven. He wants to bless you with all spiritual blessings in a heavenly realm. Hallelujah. Right now, every oppressing evil spirit, every mind-blinding spirit, every unholy thing, every power of fear that has dominated your life, I break the power of it right now in the name of Jesus. You go free. For everyone who recognizes who Jesus is and the gift that God has and the authority of his word, that is a reality for you at this very moment. Ha ha. Mondo sedea. Mondo sedea. Sikonde resita pukuyeta. Now in the name of Jesus. Now in the name of Jesus. This day. I want everybody to stand with me. This day, God commissions you to allow those who can show you when you're walking in the framework of another Jesus, when you're walking in the framework of another spirit, when you're walking in the framework of another gospel, so that you begin to cooperate with Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You begin to cooperate with God, the God-man, God manifested in the flesh, Jesus. Hallelujah. You begin to cooperate with the Holy Ghost and not another spirit. You begin to move out in the gospel of the kingdom, hallelujah, which is an authority to live in righteousness, joy, and peace in the Holy Ghost. The gospel, which is the ability to declare the good news to the poor, to bind up the broken in heart, proclaim liberty to the captives, the opening of the prison doors to them that are bound. Good news, the gospel of Christ Jesus, a total liberation from death and the power of sin and Satan. The glory of a new creation that has come forth by the working of the Holy Ghost. I'm going to tell you something. There's not a person that you meet that doesn't want a new heart and a new spirit and doesn't want to know God. There's not a person that you meet. And you're going to have to understand how to break through the lies. Oh, I know God. You're going to have to understand by the Spirit of the Lord how to break through those lies that they have and not leave them thinking that they know God when they don't know Him, and you know they don't know Him. And God will show you. He'll show you how. He'll show you. He'll begin to move through you and speak through you in ways that you could never possibly speak, and things that you could never do of yourself. He'll do through you by the power of His presence in your life. I want every one of you today just to determine you're going to be more faithful to the things of the Spirit of God, to the gospel, the way Jesus preached it, the way he said to do it. To Christ Jesus, to recognize who He is, that He's the same yesterday, today, and forever, and He does not change. He's exactly right now with the same disposition and attitude and wanting the same things from us that He declared in the four gospels. Nothing's changed. Just sits in the majesty of His glory right now, and the glory that He had with the Father before the world began. That's changed. He's not the lowly Lamb of Galilee anymore. Hallelujah. He's God the Word, exalted above every power and every name. Jesus. 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 Right now, just receive that which the Holy Ghost would supply to you. Just lift your hands towards heaven. Just receive right now in Jesus' name. The ability to be able to discern good from evil. The ability to discern the Spirit of God. The ability to be able to discern the spirit of bondage from the spirit of sonship. Huh? The ability to be able to discern the spirit of fear from the spirit of power. You got power over nothing. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Nothing. Hallelujah. Nothing. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Today, if Satan still holds you in his power, God wants to break off that stronghold. Somebody said, how can I know? If you're not living under the power and the authority and the rule and the dominion of Christ Jesus as sovereign God and ruler. He would say that Jesus is Lord. Well, Jesus said, many people say that are going to say that I am Lord. They're going to say that God is absolutely my Lord, that Christ Jesus is absolutely my Lord. And He said, they're not coming in. Jesus revealed that many people that say that they're Christians are not going to heaven. They're not making heaven. Because He said, you don't do the will of the Father. Father wants to make it easy for you. He wants to change you so that the spirit of the world is no longer on you. The spirit of compromise is no longer on you. That there is no justification for sin in your life. Praise God that He's given us the ability to repent for sin, not to justify it. And the sin is something that needs to come to an end in your life. And it ain't a hard thing. It's a wonderful thing. It's a beautiful thing. That's the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God doesn't like sin. The Spirit of God hates evil. The Spirit of God loves righteousness. The Spirit of God is at enmity against the world. The Spirit of God is pure. Spirit of God is glorious, filled with all power and authority to deal with everything that opposes God and His will. Come on. Today, if you don't know for an absolute certainty that you live under the sovereign lordship of Jesus Christ, He is sovereign ruler. He's not just Lord. He's ruler. He's master. You're servant. You live to do His will. Then today, God wants to change your heart. He wants to change your life. He wants to cause you to know. Father wants you to know certainty. I can tell you right now, I know that my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. I want you to know that I know that I'm one with Him, that I'm His favorite son. And He wants you to know the same thing. to know and to believe the love that God has for you. See, this is the spirit the Lord has given us. God is love. He that dwells in love dwells in God. Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment. For as he is, so are we right now in this world. Powerful identity. Today, if you cannot say, I know that God the Father, God Christ Jesus, and God the Holy Ghost lives in me, walks in me, is the power and the authority over my life, Father wants to change that. He wants you to know. He wants you to be certain. He wants you to wake up in the morning with great excitement. He wants you to walk out of here with great excitement. God is in me. This is an amazing thing, but God is in me. I don't know how it can be. I'm not certain of all the dimensions of it yet, but he's in me. He's in me. I'm in him and he's in me, and he's invited me to come and live here and dwell here with him for eternity. People, when this becomes a living reality to you, it's going to be hard for you to quit talking about it. I have some people tell me that about a person who was, I believe they were born crippled. They weren't born crippled, they were crippled most of their life. They got healed in one of our meetings. And he's always talking about it. Of course he is. And every meeting, all he does, on Sunday, all he does is stand up and walk around. That's all he does. He don't have to say nothing. He stands up and walks around. And the place just goes wild. Because he grew up, it's a community he grew up in. Everybody knows everybody. Here's this guy who walks around. Tell me Jesus isn't alive. Look at him walking around. Hallelujah. I mean, to have the reality that God wants us to have in our life of who he is in us. And people, this is something that begins today and grows and matures every day, so long as you're willing to acknowledge God, so long as you're willing to declare and get excited about it. You may start off saying, I don't understand anything about this, but Lord, you said you're in me, so I'm happy about it. I don't understand it. I can't imagine how it would be, but I'm just excited about it. I believe you. You're in me. And then that grows into, wow, God is in me. God the Father lives. God the Holy Ghost is here. And then it grows into a great boldness and authority in the Spirit. Where you can ask whatever you want and God will do it. Where you lay hands on the sick and they recover. Where the contrast between good and evil becomes so bright. Ooh. Where Satan has to listen to everything you say. And you don't want to hear nothing he's got to say. Amen. Hallelujah. Today is the day of salvation. Today, if you're oppressed in any way with sickness or disease or sin, any form of addiction, today the Lord wants you to go free. He's watching over his word. He trembles, passionately trembles with expectation and excitement to bring his word to pass in your life. If there's any kind of oppression in your life or addiction in your life or sin in your life, sickness in your life today, the Jesus Christ of the Bible, the one who is alive right now and present here in this place, wants to change everything. He wants to fill you with heaven. Hallelujah. Somebody say, well, why is that not so many people's experience? Because so many people choose their own way after they chose Jesus. Or I should say, he chose them and they responded. And they want to go on in the argument. And they want to go on in the fuss. And they want to go on in the doubt. And they want to go on in picking and choosing whatever it is they think they need to do. God help us. And all that. That's why they miss out on the good things. There's no witness and testimony as to the truth and the validity of God's word. All we have to do is choose God. Choose to walk in his spirit. Choose to walk and live in Jesus. Hallelujah. Choose to come live and walk in the living word that the biblical word describes to us so we can understand most perfectly. Hallelujah. Anybody here today, if you are uncertain as to whether or not your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, today we want you to be certain. Today, if you're uncertain as to whether or not your life has been changed and you've been made holy and acceptable to God,
been given the spirit of sonship, made a new creation. What beautiful and wonderful language that you used by the Lord to describe what he's done for us. Hallelujah. Through this so great a salvation. Today's your day. Right now is your time. If you've never been baptized in the Holy Ghost with the outworking of this language of the Spirit, these tongues of fire, today's your day. Linger no longer, delay no more. Just receive right now. Just receive. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Touch you. Just receive. Begin to let God move in your heart with faith. Begin to let God move in your heart. It doesn't matter where you've been. It doesn't matter what you've done. Just take a hold of the grace of Christ Jesus. Just take a hold of the blood of Jesus Christ. Just take a hold of the presence of the living God, the Spirit of the Lord. Let change begin. Today, if you want to call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and make him ruler of your life, he will come and deliver you from the stronghold of Satan. It's your choice. If you want to continue on in sin, it's your choice. If you want to continue on under the dominion of a satanic realm, it's your choice. Don't sit around, though, and talk how bad people are when you're just as bad. You just have a different flavor of sin. Because I'm telling you, somebody said, well, my sin doesn't hurt anybody else like somebody else's sin does. No, your sin is against God, and against him alone do you sin. And it hurts him more than you can understand, and it hurts you. And it hurts those who are close to you, your friends. People are always being hurt by sin. Believe this, the wages of sin is death. It will create a whirlwind of corruption. God will not be mocked. Anyone who sows to the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. Sin does its damage. It does its destructive work. No matter how harmless you may think yours is. Today, change is for you. Today, the Lord Jesus calls you. Will you come? Will you surrender your life to him? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Will you let the Holy Spirit fill you right now? Just let the Spirit of the Lord begin to just overwhelm you. Everyone standing in here, just let the Spirit of the Lord, let the Holy Ghost have free course in your life. Let the Spirit of the Lord just begin to move through you with praise and with thanksgiving. Doesn't have to necessarily be very loud. Just begin to yield yourself to him. Just begin to yield yourself right now. Let your Spirit of the Lord take over your spirit. Let the Spirit of the Lord overwhelm your spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Do not spend another day under the tyranny of Satan, under the influence of the one who hates you so much, whose purpose is to destroy your life with his sin and iniquity. Do not live another day that way. But right now in Jesus' name, receive an understanding to know the Lord. Those of you who do not know him, those of you who seem to fail to really grasp who he is, this day, right now, at this moment in time, receive an understanding so that you may know him. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we pray the Spirit of wisdom and revelation fill you in the knowledge of the Lord, that your eyes will be opened so that you may see what is his great riches, his inheritance that he has in you. What is the exceeding greatness of his power that is given to you? There's two things I want you to do. First and foremost, I want to pray with everybody who wants prayer. I don't care what your problem is. I don't care what your issue is. If fear is able to take you, for example, and you're not able to stop it, today God wants to show you how you can submit yourself to the Word, His Word and His Spirit, so that fear cannot touch you and reign over your life. If sickness or disease is in your life, Father wants to touch your body and show you how you can receive from Him that touch of heaven that fills you with life in every cell of your body. Sickness shall not have any more dominion over you any more than sin. You just need encouragement. Something's going on in your life. You just need encouragement. You just need a jolt, as it were, of faith. Whatever it is, we're here to pray with you and for you. We know this. I know this. I know that the anointing of the Holy Ghost will flow through me to you. And through my life, Christ Jesus will touch you. I pray that you would come and you'll know that if you just come and present yourself before the Lord, that you're going to receive all that you have need of. Because it takes both. It takes both. Both is essential. And then I also want every one of you, just, I want you to honor the Lord with your giving. And you know what? Listen, let me say this to you. The Lord's really dealing with me on where I need to trust Him more that would result in me moving in a greater realm of faith. Hear me. Because I'm telling you right now, there is a supernatural realm of supernatural supply in every dimension that Father wants us to have. And we've got to learn how to trust Him and not move in our own thinking and move in our own solutions. We've got to learn how to wait upon the Lord. And I want you to understand, as we give and honor the Lord with our substance and with the first fruits of our increase, it is an activity of waiting on the Lord and learning how to trust Him and watching Him work a miracle that He promised to work. Because He's never, ever called us to a place of obedience that He didn't bring a great reward through that act of obedience. The smallest acts of obedience create the greatest miracles of faith. I want to learn how to trust. And one of the places that we got to learn how to trust Father the most is in the realms of our finances, in the realms of our businesses, in the realms of the things that Father's entrusted us to. And we can't prioritize God. Well, we're going to take care of everything else. We'll get to you later. God, when we got a lot of money, we're going to bless you. I promise. Because it ain't going to ever happen that way. And too many people do that. Oh, we don't have nothing now, but I'm telling you, when we got something, a lot's coming your way. Ain't going to ever happen. Because only the obedience is going to produce the miracle. Can you hear me? You have to listen. Father just wants us to be willing to lay down our life. Amen. And risk everything. Hallelujah. Two things. I want to pray with you if you have any needs. If you haven't been baptized in the Holy Ghost in fire, you walk up here in expectation of being baptized in the Holy Ghost in fire, recognize that the anointing is here to do it, and it's God's will to do it, and it's going to happen as soon as you stand up here. She's just flowing. She's responding to altar call. She's first in line. And we want you to just come and worship the Lord with your giving. So just come. In Jesus' name. Right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Bodo stara mana de armosetere neati. Hallelujah.
Father, thank you for a mighty rushing wind of your Spirit. Father, we thank you for a mighty rushing wind of your Spirit. Fiery anointing of your Word. Fiery anointing of authority. In Jesus' name. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Mande brumosutia. Mambrenas sundia. Mambrenas. Bengalamosutia. Father, great passionate hunger and thirsting we ask you for. Esipana, a great anointing, a great outpouring of your spirit to your servant's life. Esaranayanda, a great capacity to receive from you in Jesus' name. Latana mum jeseteya. Langjam mum sita yeshi. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Bandura seya. In Jesus' name, Bora Sandeka. In Jesus' name, Bora Sandoste. Amakeyashi. Ha, Manavasiti. In Jesus' name, a great quickening of the Holy Ghost. Ebramandata. A great divine energy in Masataya. Great divine energy and strength. Masataria. Masataria Musati. Mandi Birushti Priti. Father, thank you for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Father, we thank you for great change in this life. Mandolosate. Filled to overflowing. Filled to overflowing. Power of God. Sita do ramando ste remande este caronosi. Ha. Beresande ekina namanje sita. Mangarefe. Esate. Behold, all things made new. Behold, change. The glorious change that only God the Holy Ghost can bring. The overflow of heaven gushing out of you like rivers. Asirinai, in Jesus' name. There it is, fire of God right there. Sitalahat. Ha. Sitalahat. Mendero potekeita. Mendero pokate si pakutaka nikita kik. Seto kinanjist. The Lord says this. He says, your thoughts aren't my thoughts. Huh? But I want my thoughts to be your thoughts, says the Lord. He says, your ways aren't my ways, but I want my ways to be your ways. Hallelujah. He said, there is no searching out my understanding, but I'll give strength to the faint and to the weak. He said, I will increase knowledge in those who ask. That's what the Lord says. Mangesht. Now, right now, in Jesus' name, every oppressing thought, every harassing, tormenting thing of the past that would continue to try to crop up and reoccur in your thinking and your mind, that would try to display before you the wrong instead of try to block the light of the right of that which God has said, it comes to an end in the name of Jesus Christ. Every oppressing, lying, tormenting thing in Jesus' name, I command every fear, every lie that the spirit of this world would speak to be now made of no effect in your life, because now the Spirit of God and now the Spirit of the Son and now in Jesus' name the Spirit of power and love begins to rise up on the inside of you, and you cooperate with it like never before. Ha! You cooperate with God like never before. I'm telling you right now, a shadow of doubt cannot exist in the light of His glory. Ha! Amen. Amen. Now, fire God comes on you. Nanje Ripana. Hallelujah. The glory of heaven. Adoramon, the rapturing, overwhelming glory of heaven. Comes on you, stays on you. Amen. Si story. Si story nost. This is what the Lord says. He said the old things have passed away and they've ceased to exist, no longer acknowledge them. Father says, behold, a new man has come forth. Hallelujah. After my image and after my likeness. Praise God for him. Andoraseya. Don't look back, for the former things should not be remembered anymore, neither should they come to mind. Hallelujah. And when they do, understand that it is the spirit of the world trying to bring you back into bondage concerning the former things, for that man does not exist. It's passed away. that person does not even exist anymore. It passed away. And the Lord just say, don't be around those who would try to look for that former person, that would try to summons, as it were, and call back up that former life. That's what the Lord says. Hallelujah. Now in Jesus' name. Now in Jesus' name. Be filled. Right out of your belly. Sakoranea. Right now. Look at me. Tokana esi. Tokana asi. Out of your belly. Andorasande. Exturamande ishipoya. Every condemning thought, everything that would try to stand against you and block your entrance into this realm, everything of the spirit of this world that would try to forbid what God has intended for you, I break its power off of you right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, that you may have a conscience clean and void of all offense, that there be no more condemnation or guilt or shame, but you be raptured in the glory that is in Jesus' name right now. Now, so you just receive. God gives it to you right now. These are yours. These things are yours. These things are yours. Hallelujah. These things are yours. Just let the glory flow up right where God said it's to come forth. Jesus said, all you have to do is recognize who I am and the gift I have. Do you recognize who Jesus is? Do you recognize the gift he has for you? Then just have it right now. Just have it right now. Hallelujah. Be filled. Be filled. Not in the intellect, not in the thinking, but in the love. Just worship him. Stand here and worship him. Just stand here and worship. Just stand here and worship. How are you doing today? What is your name?
Mariana. Thank you. Thank you.
produces the works of faith. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Este brinost. Aaron, be healed. Be healed. Be healed. This infection goes out of your body right now. This infection goes out of your body right now. I command it to go. In Jesus' name. Listen, look at me. Do you believe that the infection has to obey me? Infection has to obey pastor, correct? Is that correct? That is yes. So it happens. In Jesus' name then. When you believe, if you believe. If you don't believe, nothing happens. Somebody said, must I believe for something to happen?
Yeah,
must believe. The fire of the ghost. Paste upon a ray. Right now, in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for the overcoming blood of Jesus Christ, the overcoming name of Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus, right now, by the power of the living God, Father, I thank you that the Spirit of the Son rises up against bondage. I thank you, Father, that the Spirit of God rises up against the spirit of the world. Thank you, the Spirit of power and love. That's an excellent spot for her. Rises up against the spirit of fear. Father, I ask you right now in Jesus' name to cause India to begin to become extremely emotional and excited about the things of heaven. Now I speak life into your body, all pain, all joint pain, everything that would come against your body and your spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Is there anybody in here? You suffer joint pain in your joints, huh? I'm gonna pray for that here in just a minute. Feel right now, see if this joint pain's already gone. There's a crazy thing called fibromyalgia. It's just a demonic thing. It creates joint pain, all kinds of muscle pain, tissue pain. With the name of Jesus, I break the power of pain. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Listen, what is it that you want the Lord to do for you? What do you want? You can have anything you want, sweetie. What is it? What would you like? You want the baptism of the Holy Ghost? Now, in the name of Jesus, right now, I command you to be baptized in the Holy Ghost. Out of your belly flows. Sataramote. Sataramote. Sataramase. Astateki namboke epa. Astitere etu susaranate. Mandalabo, be filled with the Spirit. Mandom balesi richda, be filled. Mangoranan jesita lobost. Hallelujah. Mambronan jesike neme. Yep. And never stop. Let that flow come stronger. Holy Ghost, thank you for that. Rasta branadeshi bandeleapoya. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for a great outpouring of your Spirit in the nation of India. Hallelujah. Seteruste remeste pegiast. Manda ki ata apro asitene epetushi aromonzande. Hallelujah. Hekena monjest. Hale mangea te boche baya. Hey, a spiritual woman. A woman of the Spirit of God. Oh, woman of the Lord, handmaiden of the living God. Setoko Raman Jesse. Walk in the Spirit. Live in the Spirit. Be continually filled with the Spirit. Ha! Let the rivers of the living water from heaven flow out of your innermost being. Halabaso de Ramonde. From this day forward. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Monje Rasadai Mengoste. Name Bonga, now all the powers of doubt and uncertainty. Hallelujah. Has to leave you alone. Can't mess with you. The flow of heaven, the confidence in God fills you. Zuzu. Zurete. Zurimande esepe. Eze guramaste. Eze duramangeste. Vele mangambro sekane mengese kurustai. Monge este berinai. And with the tongues, let there become an interpretation of tongues. Huh. With the flowing of the Spirit of the living God through your innermost being, let there come great exploits of faith.
Let there become great exploits of the working of the gifts of the Spirit through your life in Jesus' name. Let there come forth a great thunderous prayer through your life. Let there come forth a great supplication in the Spirit to see things that are in the earth changed by heaven moving in. To see things that are in the earth arrested because you take hold of the power of the living God and speak the authority that Christ Jesus gives. Hallelujah. Now you do this. You do this from this day forward. You just do it. You speak out of heaven. You speak by the authority of heaven. Command devils to obey. Situations and things to change. Zurast. Ipikaya. Ipikaya. Ipikaya mando. Ipikaya mando. Ha ha. Epikaya mando siramande. Lasadaya papana epianase. Non deo will see me. Now the power of God would come and flow through you in a greater dimension. Quit holding back the move of God. Quit preventing the move of God. Quit saying no to the move of God. Say yes. Flow. Operate. Function. Hallelujah. Quit struggling. Start dancing. Quit resisting. Start moving. Hallelujah. Eshinaya. Mangadeh. And just start laughing. Don't get all bogged down. Mangadeh. Just start rejoicing in God. Amen. Just rejoice in God. I said just rejoice in God. I said just rejoice in God. If all you know is John 3:16, you should be rejoicing. Fire God on you in Jesus' name. Father, thank you for your blessing. Power of the Holy Ghost. The power of the Holy Ghost. I take a hold of the authority of God and I speak into your life. The power of the Holy Ghost works in your body and your spirit. Hallelujah. Alive from the dead, says the Lord. Amen. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Just lift your hands towards heaven. Somebody said, shouldn't we be sad and sorrowful? No, you should be glad and joyful. I command you to be healed in Jesus' name. I command your body to obey the word of God. Hallelujah. And let me ask you this. When are you going to be healed? Oh, good. Just checking. See, that's the way the Lord said it. We don't like to say it that way. We like to say, by his stripes, we will be healed. Or by his stripes, we are healed. Or by his stripes, I've already been healed. And all it waits, it's just like salvation. All God waits for me to do is agree with him and conform to his word. Mariana, things are happening over there. I see change. I see change. Hallelujah. In a mighty name of Jesus. Hey, weapons of your warfare are carnal. They're mighty through God. Sit there and modest. Somebody said, well, I'm just moody. Well, then quit being moody. Sometimes I just get emotional. Well, just stop that right now. Amen. Quit being swayed by thoughts and opinions contrary to the word of God. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Because the Spirit of the Lord is upon you. He's anointed you. Did you know that? You know that. The river of God flows through you. The power of God flows through you. Isn't that wonderful? Hallelujah. Ha-ha. Isn't that wonderful? Isn't that wonderful? How God just uses us. Can you just imagine what more he'll do with us as we just agree with him? Can you just imagine? Can you just imagine what God's going to do with you as you agree more with him? Huh? Can you just imagine? Hallelujah. When you just stop agreeing with any imagination or any thought contrary to his thoughts, which his word declares. Did you know his word declares his thoughts? Out of your belly flows gushings of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. I break off the old sorrow and hurt and pain in Jesus' name. Now in Jesus' name, receive beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Right now. Right now. Hey, if don't worry if men reject you, God accepts you all the more. Huh? When no man will stand beside you, God's just that much more, just that much closer because he's got that much less competition. Ah! Hallelujah. So be filled. So be filled. So be blessed. So look into the future and see blessings. I said look into the future and see provision. I said look into the future and see promotion and the great good things of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I say look into the future and see the good things of God. See heaven. See miracles. See signs and wonders. See mount the rest of the day. In Jesus' name. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. 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 Now in Jesus' name, now you'll be able to also interpret. And with that comes the interpretation of tongues. And with that comes all the other good things too. Hallelujah. Asaterenea. Just live like that and you can have whatever you want. Just live like that and you can have whatever you want. Just live like that. Make your delight in the Lord. Let the Spirit of the Lord have free course in your life and you have whatever you want. What do you want?
Just satisfied with the anointing that I have. If I have anything, I need more.
Okay, you have something. He's giving you an anointing that you may know him. The anointing that we received from him teaches us to abide in it. Jesus. Now in Jesus' name. Let me just tell you right now, finding your identity in the world is a trap. Yes, yes. Finding your boast in the world and the things that you do and what, it's a trap. Don't do it. Don't do that. Just lift your hands towards heaven. Let the Lord touch you now. Satan, you have no right to harass, beat up, afflict, and torment this life. Father, I ask you to cause a man to be strengthened by your spirit right now to realize that that's true, so she won't listen anymore to lies. If you believe lies, you'll be damned. If you believe lies, someone comes along lies to you, they can steal everything you got if you believe them. And they say to you, give me all of your money, give me all the money that you have, and I'll give you 10 times more. And you believe a lie, you give them all their money, your money, huh? They steal everything from you, have nothing. Don't believe the lies. The lies is a thief. Lies are thieves, killers, robbers. Believe the truth. You should know the truth. The truth should make you free. You have joint pain. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command you to be healed from your pain and the pain of your body. And the pain of your soul, your spirit, in Jesus' name. Both of them have to go. You know, layers can get created in our life that keeps us from easily receiving all the Father gives. If there's no layers of ignorance, if there's no layers of offense and pain and problems and issues and unforgiveness and all the rest of the stuff, and failure, and your heart is tenderized and wide open, there's no layers. Everything God has is yours. You can have it, move in it. And overnight grow into the full maturity of it, as it were. At least always having a continual ongoing growth in it, if nothing else. Ongoing blessing. Blessed of all spiritual blessing in many places. That is the truth. If it's not a reality in our life, then we have to just step back and say, wait a second, something's not working right. Huh? It's just like you shake the board and it's not floating. Or if you shake the board and it's not doing what it's supposed to be doing, you say, well, there's something's wrong. And you go, well, that's just the way it is. Sorry, take it or leave it. This is the way it is. You go back and back. You go back to the shaping room and you shape it to make it do what it's supposed to do. We have to look at the same thing in our lives. And we say, Lord, you said you blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. And not blame him and say, well, what's wrong? Say, Father, show me. Let's shine the floodlight of heaven upon my shoulder. And let me see the things that would hinder me from receiving that which you have for me. So right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I speak life into your spirit. That all these things have to melt. They have to be broken from off of you. God watches over his word to perform it and his purpose to let the oppressed go free. And then to say, just stand in your oppression for a little bit longer and just be miserable. Maybe you'll appreciate the blessings later. He watches over his word with anxiousness to make sure that everyone goes free. That no longer would the enemy be able to stand in between you and the Lord and say, no, you can't do it. You cannot bless him. To whether there would be a power and authority in heaven to be able to hinder you from that which Christ Jesus purchased for you. This day, in the name of Jesus Christ, this day you set God before you, and don't you take your eyes off of him. Not for a moment. And he will teach you how to love righteousness and hate evil. He'll teach you how to walk in the realms of his anointing. He'll teach you how to receive all the blessings that he freely gives, spiritually, physically, and materially. The struggle will come to an end. The struggle will come to an end first and foremost because it won't matter anymore. Because all you trust now is found in the Lord, and all you want is what he's got. And then what's followed by that, having put all your trust in the Lord, is a supply from heaven that can't be stopped. One thing after another. One, you go from blessing to blessing. From glory to glory. From riches to riches. From one anointing to the next. From one encounter to the next. This is what Father has. You can't turn that away. You can't possibly see. No one in this place could possibly see, or anyone watching or listening by web could possibly see some better alternative. To make something, some little frivolous thrill, some emotional button of value exalted above all this. No, it's insanity. Right? So right now in Jesus' name, it's wisdom of the Holy, the wisdom of God. Have any pain in your body right now? Feel good? Well, in Jesus' name, from this day forward, feel this way all the time by the acknowledgement of the Lord, by the acknowledgement of Christ Jesus. Because if you do not read your Bible, say your prayers, you're never going to be good. You're never going to walk in the goodness. Just in this relationship. Stay here. It gets bigger. It gets better. Then let the Lord look at you and say, what ails your praise? What ails your thanksgiving? What ails your rejoicing? Because it's just fully healthy, strong, boisterous, active. Jesus. Great peace. Great peace, Bill Johnson. Great peace. Great peace from the Prince of Peace. Great peace. Great peace, Bill Johnson. I love watching Bill ride the waves because he does it so great. He does it so excellently. I want to see him ride the waves of the Spirit so well. You too. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ambrosatara veveki dishi. Balanda beresina. Balanda resipena. Ezebronosinda. Ebresuntanda libisht. In the name of Jesus. Walk in that anointing. Hallelujah. Walk in the anointing. Walk in the anointing of the Holy Ghost. walk in the anointing. Somebody says, I want to. You can. His Father's empowered you. Daniel, he's given you more than Daniel of old. All you have to do is be hungry and thirsty for those things that are yours to be revealed and manifested through your life. That works the work within our heart to be able to receive. That works the work within our heart to just release that which Father has given. Just let and let God be God. Let Him flow through this. With greater praise. Say with greater praise. With greater excitement. With greater joy. With greater expressions of the Holy Ghost. With greater passion. With greater demonstration. Amen. Well, for everybody that's left, we have church tonight at 6 o'clock. Prayer starts at 5. Hug a bunch of people. Hug everybody that you come in contact with before you leave. Bless them in Jesus' name. If someone's out on the floor, do not mess with them. Leave them alone. If you want, you can stay here all day. We paid for the building. It's ours.